come from your backbone and ribcage. We know it don't come from there. Why would the Qur'an say that? It comes from your backbone and your ribcage.
Are you scared of the camera?
No, it's all right. No, film it. Now, why? Now, guys, why would the Qur'an say your semen comes from your backbone and your ribcage?
As a new rule.
It doesn't come from there. Show me the doctor, because I can show you the doctor that says it doesn't. Well, show me down there.
But you yourself proved that when you eat food to sustain yourself,
guys, already there's an issue with the Quran right now. He's made a mistake.
There's no issue.
The semen, just now.
There's been scientists that confirmed it.
Show me, name one. Name one now. Name one to now. Name one now, please. Go on then. Show me one that says semen comes from the rib cage and the backbone.
No.
This is what we're dealing with. Show me the scientists. Show me the scientists. That's okay. You're struggling,
aren't
you?
Don't show me your iPad because I've seen it on the YouTube.
I don't care. It's time for kryptonite to come out. It's time for kryptonite to come out. Yeah? Because you know what this does? It crumbles all your fallacies into dust.
It just exposes your lies.
How's it expose my lies?
Can I show you?
Go on, show me the lies. Let's have a look.
Give me 5 minutes, yeah.
Let's have a look at the lies. Go on.
This same science that you're relying on is such a change.
For 2 minutes, I'll try and find it.
You're coming back though, right?
No,
okay, go on, crack on. Alright, crack on. Alright, let's have a look.
The science that you're relying on is always something to change. You're always developing an understanding. And as you said, things are always being caught in the body.
Yeah, but listen, guys, we have to agree on something. Okay, we have to agree on something, right? We just agreed on it. We're going to go over it again, one more time. Right.
Where does the sperm come from?
No, let's have a look. Let's go over this one more time. Okay. This is what it says in the Quran, yes? 86:16. He was created from the fluid ejected. You know sperm, yes? Emerging between the backbone and the ribs.
What?
We know sperm don't come from the backbone and the ribs. No, it doesn't. It only means one thing. Right.
Just type on YouTube. Yeah. Just look at this. It won't take much of your time, 4 or 5 minutes.
And what?
Okay, and it just shows what kind of thing.
No, tell us what it is first. You can't just make a claim or do. Once again, remember I said to him, I will do you for libel right now. I'll do you for libel. So show me the lies. You say it takes 4 or 5 minutes.
You call someone a terrorist.
Hold on a second. Have we all got 4 or 5 minutes to spare? I have. Show me.
Looks all right, sir. You have headphones, do you want to listen?
Yeah, go on, put it up. Let's hear it. No, tell us. We can't hear anything.
Okay, backwards.
Yeah, go on.
Give you headphones.
No, tell everyone wants to hear it.
I'm saying to watch it.
Yeah, go on.
That you lied. You don't want to
what I lied about. Tell me specifically what I lied about. I've seen the video. But tell me specifically what I lied about in the video.
What's going on here, man?
You only want to hear what you want to hear.
No, tell me specifically. I've watched the video. Tell me what I lied about in the video.
What's this going on, man?
Tell me what I lied about in the video.
That's my point.
Now, on camera, film him. On camera for reference, I'm going to do this guy for libel. I want to take a picture of him. I'm going to do you for libel. I'm going to hand you a writ. Next time I see you, I'm going to hand you a writ that you had to fill out. Yes, you're going to fill it. I'm going to do you for libel. Because you showed me nothing that I lied about. Now, are you doing that? Do you want to go over this again? Show me what I lied about. See, you showed me nothing. Okay. Now, meanwhile, this guy's cracking himself. Right? We're going to look at this. Right, okay, great. Right? Bye-bye, Mr. Friend. Okay.
So the video came down.
Nothing.
We could step in the ring with Mayweather. I didn't realize it's not going to happen.
He created fluid, right? Emerging between the backbone and the ribs. Right. Now we know, you're not Muslim. Okay, be backbone and the ribs. Now we know just now, sperm does not come from your backbone and your ribs. Right? Doesn't come from the backbone and ribs. Now, to back it up, Hair is my doctor. Sperm is produced in the testicles, right, which is found in the scripture.
Each
sperm cell, blah, 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 blah. Hair it is here. That's the only place where sperm is produced. Right, hair it is here. It's not produced between the rib and the backbone. The only thing in the rib and the backbone are the stomach, the liver, the kidneys. No sperm is produced there. Why would the Quran say it's produced there? Because God should have known that, shouldn't he? But God should have known that, shouldn't he? So he got it wrong. So he got it wrong. No, I've been over this before. Well,
do you believe that?
You got 1 week to do it.
I believe everything around the Quran, man.
For real? You really believe that? You believe that it comes from your backbone? The sperm comes from your backbone?
From backbone and your rib. You know that's up here. You know your sperm.
All right.
All right.
Let me give you a little question, yeah? If a man has had his backbone, meaning like his spine severed, yeah, meaning that he's got like a type 6 break, meaning that he's paralyzed, could he produce sperm still?
I ain't read the Quran, bro, so I don't really know.
Could he have children?
I ain't got no children yet.
My friend's got children. He's got a type 6 break. He can't move his neck. But what works down there works. Ain't nothing to do with the backbone,
the
my brother.
Got that wrong, didn't it? So it can't be from God if you got that mixed up. Created from the backbone. Created from the backbone, emerging from between the backbone and the ribs.
And the ribs.
We know it don't come from there.
You need them organs, though, innit? You need them organs to survive. So still, you need a whole part of it. But I don't get me wrong, I get what you're saying.
There's a diagram. Already, now. Already,
no, he's proved it to me.
Okay, look at this. Okay, look at this.
I know where it comes from.
Now, we can break this down in many ways.
So if they rub your back here, you might bust a nut.
Look at this. So, sperm itself, the testicles only produce 5% sperm. The prostate gland produces 30%, right? And the sena vice guy, which is this one here, produces 70% sperm. The backbone's up here. Nothing's produced around there. So why would the Quran say it's produced up in the backbone? Got it wrong. Not from a
I'm
God.
I'm sure you can find something in all them scriptures. Any religious scripture, you can find something and just say, oh,
because I could do one more if you want, one more error in the Quran. You want to do another?
Can you do an error?
Can you do an error
in the Bible? Can you do it in the Torah?
Okay, the other area. Now, the Quran does. This is where it gets it wrong again. It says, then we made sperm drop into a clinging clock, and we made the clinging clock into a lump of flesh. Remember, flesh. Yeah. And then we made from the lump of flesh bones, and we covered the bones with flesh. Right. So you get them that first foot came the flesh.
What happened to the nerves?
And then second, second came the bones. Right. Yes. First came the flesh, then came the bone. Let's look at Let's look at what the doctors say. What happens? Right.
Yeah, this is doctor.
Let's break down who the doctor is.
Yeah, but you're lying or
what? Let's break down the doctor.
People came
hold on a second.
Animals.
Let's be. Calm down.
You can't.
Let's
rely on
what's got? Okay.
No,
what's,
no, no,
okay.
I'm
let's go. Let's go on this doctor.
Science by definition.
Doctor Robert E. Edwards. Now listen to this. When he first started the first world IVF center. I think he's qualified. He started the first. Why? Okay.
I can say to you, but this guy started this and having
a. My friend, you can quite. He's still a professor at University of Cambridge.
Of course, yeah, I could.
Right, so you can research him. Right, here it is here. Soon after conception, the embryo differences into 3 layers of cells at the same time. Now, bones and skin are all developed together. Why would the Quran say they come one after the other?
Another technological advancement. We're going to have advancements to see that the Quran is a lot more accurate.
Bones, skin doesn't come before bones.
That's the understanding now.
Skin don't come before bones.
That's the understanding
now. Can you imagine?
Look, you can take this man. You can take this man's word as law. That's up to you. That's your choice.
Look at this.
And it's really good. It's really
3 layers are developed at the same time. Look, the middle layer, which is the baby's bones, as well as the muscles and kidneys and sex organs, the inner layer becomes the digestive system, and the outer layer develops into the hair, skin, and eyes.
So he knows everything.
All at the same time.
He knows everything, and that's the end of it, right? So there's no need for developing an understanding.
Where did you guys get that first came the skin and then came the bones? That's wrong, isn't it?
Well, by definition, it's the words.
It's wrong, though, isn't it?
By definition, the words of the creator.
Well,
so
what? Okay.
So something we don't.
So
understand.
What you guys have to
myself,
do?
Myself, I'm not knowledgeable enough to go and do the.
Okay, well, show me someone knowledgeable enough. Come, I'm wasting my time here.
You're not knowledgeable enough.
Okay.
You rely on a flipping white man from Cambridge.
The Quran could only come from, as you said, an illiterate man.
It's not.
Not from a god.
There's always going to be development.
Because God would have known this. God would have known this.
And maybe he does.
Yes?
And maybe he does know this.
God. But why do you write that wrong?
Because the advancements that we
stop
have
making
is
excuses.
Only showing,
stop making listen. Excuses for this concept. Yes. Stop make just accept.
Stop
it's
listening.
Wrong.
Stop listening then, to what the white man feeds you. Because if he feeds you stuff, he's going to tell you like
second.
He told you before in the past.
Muhammad,
like he
on
told you in the past.
On a second.
That you're inferior as a black person. Now he's telling you.
So
stuff
why are you listening to a white man?
I'm not listening to him. I'm listening to words of the.
Now hold on a second. Hold on a second.
And I believe it.
Muhammad was a white man. Muhammad was a white man.
No, we went over this before.
No, hold on a second.
We went over
Muhammad
before.
Was a white man, we so why are you listening to a white man?
It was weetish.
It says in
you
hadith
got rebuttaled on that.
It says, Muhammad said, Muhammad was a white man. So why are you listening to a white man?
400 years ago, Europe was in a dark age.
It's weetish.
And what was wrong with that?
I mean, like,
what was wrong with that? They were still alive.
They were still alive. Dark ages, they don't have enough knowledge to run out their own life.
Okay, great.
Of course
they need to go to university. So they went to the university of
Arab. I don't accept it. They went to the University of Alexandria in Africa.
No.
That's not Arab.
No.
What are you talking about?
Arab, there was an issue with
Alexandria.
Believe in Arab.
And as well as that, the Lyceum and the Academy
in
Greece.
Not believe.
But you say that Muhammad is Arab. Where did he get that from?
You're getting mixed up. You're getting caught up in words.
Did I say it? Did that come out of
nowhere? No. Alexandria told you that?
So you know.
Do you have a picture of him?
Where did you get that notion?
That's what he's saying.
You
know
okay,
that,
but you said
that
I.
I am
my own person.
Thank you.
How would you know that?
I'm sorry.
Are you finished?
Okay.
Say you
we are joined by the
you know.
No. Say you know.
Sorry. Okay, cool.
So you tell me, what do you know? How do you know?
Okay. Now let's work with something that you can experience both yourself. Right. Are you conscious and aware? Are you conscious and aware? Are you conscious and aware? So how do you know?
How do I know? Because I'm conscious. I can feel, see, touch, smell.
Okay, great. So going... Okay, great. So going with one of those senses, touching, what is it that knows that you're touching
okay,
something?
Okay, so why are you under an analysis? My body, me, my nervous system.
Yeah, but what is it that knows you have a body?
What? No, me. The consciousness.
But what is it that knows that you are me? Me feeling. Yo, but yeah, but hold on, hold on. What is it that knows? There's a state of knowing all the time, isn't there?
Yeah, go on.
There's something that constantly knows something.
Yes.
So what is it that?
Exactly.
So consciousness.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, would you say that's your true nature, or would you say you're the body is your true nature?
My consciousness is my true nature.
Would you
my
say
body, my consciousness will make my body do whatever I'm
right? Okay, great. Okay, yeah. Because anything that you do is a conscious thought first,
course,
isn't it?
Yes, yeah,
your clothes, the way
yes.
You first think about it, then you do it.
Yes,
right. Okay, great. So, looking at the world around us, because everything's made of matter, that's what you are.
Yeah.
So there has to be consciousness before the matter, right? A thought behind the matter.
I don't know about that.
Well, think about it. If 70%, if 70%
of the human form, I don't know. Could you ask me consciousness in a level of a human form? I don't know any of the consciousness, so I can't know that.
Okay.
I can believe that.
Okay.
But you said you
so
know.
So think of it like this. Now, would you agree that for something to be like everything's mathematics around us? You know about fractals and Fibonacci. It's all around us. The trees are in a fractal state.
Yeah. That's what
geometry.
Got
okay.
This,
okay. Great. So.
No.
If we have.
That's in nature.
So like
know,
this is no. A tree,
yeah,
a tree
know,
for fractal.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Make
so
nature.
What I'm trying to say to you, if in nature, trees, the sun, the planetary system are all following a mathematical sequence.
Yeah.
Now, to have mathematics, there has to be a mind behind mathematics.
Who told you following in the sky, you're saying, basically in the universe, there's a mathematical system, you're saying.
My friend.
You can observe that.
My friend.
You can observe that, yeah, you can observe that.
Okay, but let's break it down like this for you.
But to make meaning of it.
Okay, but think of it like this.
It's a pattern to make a meaning of it.
Because, like, remember, time in itself is an illusion, as Einstein said. You understand that, yes? Do you understand? Time is illusion? Okay, how many hours are there in a day? in a day? How many hours are there in a day?
According to how they defined it, 24.
How many hours in a day? 24? All right, next question. How many hours are there at night time? How many hours at night?
Whoa.
Can you see why time's an illusion?
It changes.
But I said how they're defined.
No, I'm just saying.
It changes.
You just say how many hours are there in a day. I said to you, how many hours are there at night?
You've changed my question.
You can easily look at it.
I know, I'm just saying to you. Right.
I know.
So just say time is an illusion, just to prove it to you. Right. So going by that, I said to you, for there to be...
No.
Okay. So for there to be mass within the galactic scale, in nature and in the universe, there has to be a mind behind that. Yes? You don't have mathematics without a mind.
But you don't know that. That's the belief. You believe there's a mind behind it.
Anything.
You don't know. Can you see the mind? Have you met the mind? Have you ever met God or anyone else?
But if you regress, I agree. If you regress.
Hold on a second. But we need to just take it one stage at a time. I'm saying to you, for there to be a system 1 + 1 = 2, that formulation of 1 + 1 = 2, there had to be a mind behind it, right? It didn't just come out. It didn't just come out of nowhere. Yes.
Someone had to. Yes.
Right. Yeah. Great. Okay. So if you got fractal systems and geometry in the universe and in nature, geometry had to have a mind behind it. Yes. It had to have been.
Is it random?
Because mathematics don't come out of nowhere.
I believe in higher power. But I'm just saying. He said to me that.
Listen.
He said he knows.
Do not get distracted by what I believe. Just stick with what I'm saying to you. So. As far as geometry is concerned, Fibonacci, right, pi, all of these systems that we see, mathematics, right? Now, there has to be a mind behind it, right? Yes?
Yeah, that we know, yes.
Has to be, because maths is in the mind.
Maths is mind. Yeah, so, of course, and then mind is what?
Everything is.
Okay, and then mind is what? And then mind is consciousness, yes?
Yes.
Right, and consciousness is a state of being self-aware and aware, and a state of knowing. So, minus us even being here, galactically there's a state of knowing,
right now when
we try to find out what this energy is and the and essence of it, and we use quantum mechanics now, and we do simple things like the double slit experiment or entanglement, we find out that everything's connected, never separated, right? So when I hear things what Muslims will say is that Allah is separate from his creation, that don't make any sense. Because
why doesn't it make sense?
Because
I agree with a lot of the things you say, but why doesn't it make sense?
Because
why couldn't Allah created this state and we live within this?
Okay.
Why is it separate?
Because the Quran also goes to say there is nothing like the creator. That means he's separate from it. Right?
That's
completely.
Not enough answer, is it?
No, I'm just saying to you.
Okay.
I'm just saying to you. Right. Now, when you read the Torah, at least it says God is all things. He made man in his image and likeness. The problem I have with the Quran is Allah says, I didn't make man in my image and likeness. I just said be, and it was be, and it was done. But the problem is that things that he's making everybody out of.
You're filming me.
No, not you.
You're filming?
Yeah, you
filming?
Am I not allowed?
No, because I think one of your friends said, no, you don't want to be filmed.
That's
so
not his mate. That's not his mate.
Okay,
that's
then.
You can film me out, man.
All right, cool. All right. Yeah? You're good.
Okay.
Sorry.
So, like, this thing that Allah decided to make everything out of.
Gary, you know it's not.
No, I'm just giving it to you. So, this thing.
Why are you picking on Islam?
No, because.
If you're trying to say, if you're just saying really all religion.
I'm breaking it. No, listen, I'm just giving you a story. Right. So, that now, if Allah is using.
What you agree with is God is a part of that. Listen. And you can't separate it.
I'm asking you,
listen, why couldn't the creator create this?
Okay. Is God whole and complete?
My baby's right.
Is God whole and complete?
My baby's mixed.
I don't understand. I can't comprehend God.
He's whole and complete, right?
I can't comprehend.
He has to be.
You couldn't comprehend.
You're not
right. You have to be whole and complete.
I don't know.
Right. So therefore, nothing can be separated from God.
Huh?
Is a contradiction in itself.
You're not
right. I can't comprehend God.
Okay. No, but I'm saying to you, God has to be whole and complete.
But you haven't given me why God can't be separate from this system.
Because.
You're being racist saying about my son's
wife.
You don't even know my son.
Number one, he wouldn't be a God.
He looked
why?
More
right?
Why?
And number two,
why would he be a god if he could create it by being separate? Because that doesn't limit
why are you commenting on my baby's colour?
No, it does. Because what it is, if God is creating something.
Why does he have to be poor?
Sorry?
Why does he have to
be poor? What are you talking about, my God?
Because he wouldn't
colour.
Be whole and complete as a
you're
god.
Big man.
I don't understand.
Come on, man.
Gods. Okay, the god. I'm giving you the concept of God. The concept of God is whole and one and complete. By saying God is separate, that means there's a part of him that's been displaced.
Don't do that. Don't
that means he's not whole and complete.
No, but maybe he's whole and complete over there. And this
you can't be whole and complete over there.
Why?
And over here.
Why?
Remember, God.
Yeah, leave it
because
as
that's
that.
What you say. Muslims say it's separate.
Leave it as that.
I'm asking you, where are you making. Why are you saying that that doesn't make sense?
Okay. Let me give it to you from a scientific point of view. Because in a world of quantum mechanics,
of course,
what you're made from, there's no separation.
Exactly, exactly. So you're tying it in with quantum mechanics. Why are you doing that? Help me understand, as a Muslim, why are you doing that? Because I agree with a lot of the things you're saying.
Okay.
However, when we get to this point, it's like, why can't the creator
the reason
be separate
why
from
I'm tying it in with quantum mechanics, because we're made of the same stuff, right? We're made of all the matter atoms. So the quantum mechanics is the study of energetic particles, which is quantum mechanics. So when we look into quantum mechanics, we can see through a process called entanglement, there's no separation.
Okay.
So for Allah then to declare, I am separate from separation, he's going against the notion, the objective notion, that there are no separations.
But he's doing what's befitting to his power as a creator.
He can be
separate.
It could be separate. Now, if I say to you that...
And I asked you, why can't he be separate?
But because we have proven there is no separation.
Within the creation. Within the
are
creation.
You aware of quantum...
Within the creation.
Okay, honestly.
But then you started talking about God being whole.
Listen,
I don't understand.
Are you aware of quantum entanglement?
Yeah.
Are you aware of it? What is it?
Everything is made up of... Everything is entwined with each other. So the particles, as you said earlier on, the energies are transformed. So it's all one system.
Okay,
one ecosystem.
Okay, i.e. So like if this was an electron...
Yeah.
And the glove was an electron, and I cut this in half, and I put them on the other side of the world. As I do one to this, it will affect the other instantaneously. They're still connected. They're never separated. Nothing in this world
is
separated.
Wait. If you said you cut that glove in half,
yes.
Throw one on the one side here,
and the other, and then do something to one, it instantaneously affects the other, because they're still connected.
On a level.
You're talking about electrons.
Electrons. I'm just giving
yourself.
You a thing, right? So that's what I'm saying to you, because it's called entanglement. Now, every single thing is connected. We are all connected. There's no difference between my thoughts and your thoughts.
In a simple format,
yeah?
In a simple format, yeah? Quantum's this. Quantum is something which is, say, if an object is here. Like, for instance, this gentleman is behind me. In quantum mechanics, this until I disrupt my observation by looking at him, he is there and he's not there. It's in two states. So therefore, it's everything and nothing at the same time.
Then I guess we have to look at it again when it comes to consciousness, how because it's subjective, isn't it? What we perceive.
No, it's objective.
But I agree with you.
It becomes when you
perceive
it. No, but what it is.
What we perceive.
No,
yeah,
but
what
I mean.
Is subjective.
No, but yeah, exactly. So everything you're looking at now is subjective. I agree with you. But your experience of seeing is objective. You are objectively seeing something. Now, what it is subjective. What that is objective, but the process of seeing is objective. I am seeing, but what it is subjective. Yes,
because
so that's what quantum mechanics is.
Fine. A lot of it I don't disagree. A lot of it I don't understand. A lot of it I don't disagree.
I know you don't agree.
However, I don't see how you make the separation. I still don't understand it.
No, I said to you, quantum entanglement. There's nothing separating quantum entanglement.
But why do you exclude? Because you spoke about a creator for a while, and then we got to a point where you separated it. And you said that,
no, because I'm talking about in terms of what you believe in.
Because I agree with the fractals, you know, the fact that it is part of a greater scheme.
Yeah, I know it is. Yeah. So based on what you just said to me, that you're a Muslim, right?
Yeah.
Yes. So based on being a Muslim, and Allah saying that he's creating everything out of it be and it should be is incorrect.
Why is that?
Because there's no separation in nature.
Well, why can't he create this whole system?
Because it's never been proven. The opposite's been proven.
Okay, it's never been proven.
The opposite's been proven. That's fact.
No, it hasn't.
Quantum entanglement proves it.
How?
Because they've done the experiments of quantum entanglement.
How?
By splitting electrons and doing one to the other, and it affects the other one simultaneously. So I suggest to you...
Maybe with particles and...
Yeah, but that's what you're made of.
...quarks that we can't see.
Yeah, but that's what you're made of. You're made of electrons.
But that's what I'm saying. God may not be part of that system.
Okay,
so
listen.
So I'm asking you, how so like do you if touch I, the two?
Okay, cause like if I tickle your toes, if you're missing tickle your toes, you instantly feel it, right? Yes?
Yeah,
you instantly feel it. Yeah. Now, reflexology, you know what that is, right?
Yeah.
Now, a Chinese practitioner or somebody knows about it, I can massage your heart from the bottom of your feet.
Yeah.
Why? Because it's all connected as one.
Okay.
That's what reflexology is.
I understand.
Right?
I understand.
So there's no separation.
Wait,
even
but you're
you.
Making the assumption that the whole body has God and the creation within it. That's the assumption here.
What do you mean? Had the...
But I'm saying, why can't
yeah,
God
what
create
is...
the person and they have that experience and that whole
because
system?
Because what I'm trying to say to
I'm
a, you...
I want to understand.
Right? Because what I'm trying to say to you, right, that if you... Now, the world, as science is now proven, is a hologram. Yes?
Look, your science is... You
know, no, I'm just saying to you, it's a hologram. Right. So, holograms mean... You know what hologram is, right? Every part's a smaller version of the whole. That means this tiny bit, if you affect this, it affects the whole pattern.
Butterfly effect.
Smaller version of the whole. We're all connected as one. Now, for you to declare Allah is separate, he's out of the game.
But Islam,
at least,
I'm not declaring
at
Islam
least,
is
my
declaring.
Friend, at least the Torah and the Bible states God is all things and in all things.
But these revelations
right?
are from the
At least, that makes a bit sense.
But
for you guys
by
to say,
definition,
Allah steps away from
but
that.
But it's his majesty,
and
he can do it. He can do that. Why can't he do that? That's the question.
My friend,
and
I just proved to
this
you.
This is from the same lineage. It's the same
the reason why you have a problem
creator.
With this, because number one today,
yeah.
Now I've shown you three errors within the Quran. Three errors in the Quran, which then this now caps it
you
all off.
Errors,
yes, I have. I've shown you how sperm isn't created from the backbone and rib cage. I showed you how
no,
the
you
flesh.
Showed the verse and,
I showed you
and
how
I looked,
the
and
flesh.
And I actually went to one side
hold
and started
a
reading.
I showed you.
To,
I showed
like,
you how the flesh
you can't just say
isn't created
stuff.
Before the bones.
No, you didn't show.
It's created all together.
No, you didn't show.
I didn't show you.
You showed me what somebody has said in their observation.
He developed
to at the moment.
He
that's
is.
What
hold on, hold a second. He is a doctor from the University of Cambridge, and he formulated the first IVF unit. You know what that means, don't you?
I'm not disputing.
You know what IVF is,
I'm
don't
you?
I'm
not disputing what we know so far. In
you
fact,
know,
in
you
fact,
know what
I
IVF
encourage
is,
it.
Don't you?
In fact, I encourage it.
Right.
In fact,
so
I encourage
if
it.
This guy is saying,
yeah.
And remember,
but this guy
remember,
is the law, this guy is
he
the
hasn't said it. Hold on a second. He, now,
so
he hasn't
you,
said
are
it.
You telling me it's,
he
it's,
has not
we're not
going
to make any more
friend,
advancements.
Calm down.
Well,
hold on. Now, this doctor hadn't said it with any biases towards anybody. He's just giving you the facts that bones, flesh are all created at the same time.
The way I take that is that's human understanding up to this point.
Of what?
That's how I take that. I don't take that as, you know, it defines...
Human understanding.
And dismisses God.
Well, every doctor, most doctors on the world agree that bones
no, that's up to
and
you,
skin are created at the same time.
Yeah, but as I mentioned earlier...
According to the Quran,
there was a point in time
it's created
where,
one after the other.
There was a point in time where we had a lot of scientific, medical inaccuracies. But through the advancement, we
well,
were learning...
We've
learned,
got a major
we
one in the Quran.
More.
Do you believe you can live without God? Knowing God? I mean, you don't know him anyway.
Yeah, yeah, I believe you can live without...
Believing in God.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Do you believe you can live without science?
Science is a way of measuring. It's like the, for me, it's like the measuring tool, isn't it?
Well, it's the maths of.
It's the maths
everything.
Of. Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
If you eat too much,
absolutely,
die,
absolutely,
yeah.
absolutely. I don't believe that. You know, even according to Islam, I think that. You know.
No, because the prophet.
Not everyone's supposed to be a believer.
In the sense that there is no evidence saying.
Yeah,
I believe there's something greater, but I don't
yeah,
know
yeah.
what it is.
I don't believe, and I don't have this idea that everyone should be a Muslim or whatever. I believe that, you know.
No, that's good. No, it's very smart. You're doing a good debate here. You know.
Not once in Gabriel. Said, I am Gabriel to Muhammad. So it's hearsay. So there's no proof whatsoever this person who came to Muhammad was Gabriel. So there we have a massive problem. Because as we know, an introduction, a personal introduction, is the right introduction. Not me saying to you, oh, I think this guy's John. I think he's called John. And he never says who he is. And then me, and then what is it? You're left thinking his name is John.
I heard the debate with Shabir.
I know you heard the debate with Shabir. And you know what? And you know what? Shabir has never come back to me because he knows he's going to get debunked every single time. Now, Shabir picks on little tiny sheep. He never comes to the wolves. He knows he's going to get eaten. That's the problem with Shabir.
What do you say to him that he cannot reply?
Because I give him the scenario whereby who was it? That spoke to Muhammad. We don't know.
Okay.
2 weeks.
There's a problem. He never introduced himself.
No, none of us was there. We are told by Muhammad, peace be on him.
Yes.
That somebody appeared for him. He told him, read and you know the story.
Yeah, I know the story. And then who, but the problem you have now, who was the person that said it was Gabriel? A Christian.
Muhammad himself.
No, he didn't. He went to his uncle.
Regardless
wait
who
a minute,
was.
No.
He went to his uncle.
His uncle, Muhammad told this to his wife.
Yes.
Okay. And Waraka was a relative for Khadija.
Yes.
Not his uncle, by the way, to correct you. And he was
it says
a believer.
His uncle.
No, you can show me.
So you're saying it's wrong?
I don't really, uncle, you're saying relative.
No, but you see, once again, I don't want a guy putting libel on me once again.
Okay.
So let's just check.
That wasn't really the point he's getting to.
We can come to this later, but the bunch point
I get to why you're talking. Yeah, go on.
The bunch, you come up doing two things at the same time. Or you think you're Superman?
I do two things at the same time. Right now, I'm talking and moving my hand.
Okay. Now.
Right, go on.
I'm listening. I will wait.
So I want to understand why.
You please let him finish what he's doing?
Yeah, why he wasn't Gabriel. Why that wasn't Gabriel.
Because, why it wasn't Gabriel? Yeah. Because Gabriel didn't say he was Gabriel.
Or
whoever
because he didn't introduce himself.
Didn't say he was Gabriel.
Because he didn't introduce himself.
And plus, he made errors.
So because he didn't introduce himself.
My friend.
Because the evidence Muslims can use is they bring the Quran. Now.
Well, he.
Yeah, yeah, finish. I'm finding it.
Well, I don't know how we can discuss why you're doing things.
I'm listening to you. I've been doing this a long time.
You have made a mistake. You're going to find out you made a mistake. That's fine. But if you are wrong here, it's not a big deal for me. It's not going to benefit me, his uncle or not his
uncle. Make the point.
He was saying, what were you saying? That no one said that it was Gabriel, except his uncle. Yeah, that's what he said. So he's saying, he never said it himself.
No,
you were saying,
Quran is clear. If you read chapters in the Quran, what happened between Prophet Muhammad and the angel Gabriel, Quran says Muhammad saw Gabriel in more than one form, in a human form. He saw him in a human form.
He seen the angel in a human form.
In a human form. The angel can come as human form.
Okay.
Or the angel can appear in a human form.